Once you receive your PowerDash 3X from FedEx, please take it out of the shipping box and open it up to make sure there is no damage. After removing the safety foam insert, you will see the PowerDash 3X, 4 sensors, and 4 reflectors. Please turn on the PowerDash 3X to make sure it's still holding its charge after shipping. When you turn on the PowerDash 3X, all the numbers will start to run. If you hit the reset button, it'll take the numbers to zero, but they will continue to run. This is a normal function of the PowerDash 3X. Take out the sensors and reflectors to inspect them for any possible damage that could have occurred during shipping. The wire, a 10, a 20, and a 40 yard cord are located behind the flap in the top of the PowerDash 3X case. Take out the wire and separate it to ensure that you have all three sections of wire. Please also make sure that you still have the charger located in the foam insert around which the wire was wrapped. With your PowerDash 3X, you will also receive 6 tripods. Remove the tripod from its carrying case. Next, open out the legs of the tripod and secure their position by tightening the fastener. Then, use the additional adjustments on the tripods to set the tripod at the desired height for testing. Please note there is a level located at the top of your tripod to ensure the tripod is level. If you need to make additional adjustments to the tripod height, you can do so by tightening and loosening the adjustment collar. Once your tripods are set up, you can begin to place your start sensor and start reflector. You can adjust the feet on the reflector and the sensor mount by loosening or tightening the bolt on the bottom. Take the start sensor and plug it into the hole labeled S. Please ensure that the male end of the start cable is pushed all the way into its receiving female end of the start box. If it is not pushed in all the way, the timer may not work properly during testing. Once you have the start sensor plugged in, please place it at the front of the start line or in the desired position for athlete hand placement. After placing the start sensor, place the start line reflector directly across the line from the start sensor. Next, take the plastic tripod head mount that you find located on the top of the tripod, remove it, and tighten it to the bottom of a reflector. Make sure that the threaded screw end goes into the threaded hole on the bottom of the reflector. Peel off the protective reflector cover. Then, place the reflector inside the head of the tripod. Next, adjust the tripod to ensure that the reflector and head of the tripod is level. You can check this by looking at the level on the side of the tripod head. Then repeat the same step with the sensor. Tighten the plastic head mount onto the bottom of the sensor and place the sensor on top of the head of the tripod. After setting up all the sensors and reflectors, you'll be ready to plug in the additional cords for timing. As you did with the start cable, please ensure the additional cord's male ends are plugged all the way into the timing box. Lay the cords behind the box and prop the PowerDash 3X in its case. Once you've laid out your desired cord, take the female end and the male end and plug them together, ensuring that they are plugged in all the way. Then, tuck the additional cord underneath the tripod to ensure it's out of the way. Finally, adjust each sensor, including the start sensor, to ensure that the light on the back of the sensor goes off. When the light is off, this ensures that the sensor is lined up correctly. Now you're ready to run the 40 yard. To operate the PowerDash 3X, the athlete will get their start stance, put their hand down on the line, and the red light in the box will come on. The operator will hit the reset button, and when the athlete goes, the time begins to run. Once the light is on in the box, the operator must hit the red button for the timing system to run, and for the athlete's time to be recorded on the display screens on the box.